Hey everyone, it's Michael Antonovich with Swapmoto Live. We've made it to Texas for the next run of races in the 2021 Monster Energy Supercross Series, which will take place at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. We're in the thick of the title fight now, and rounds 10, 11, and 12 will take place on the same Saturday-Tuesday-Saturday rotation that we saw at Houston and Indianapolis. Riders that make it through this triple header without issue will be rewarded with points and positions in the championship at a very critical time of the season. Our trip to the track for Friday's media session was very informative, so let's cover some of the topics in this SML News Break presented by Fly Racing. The build of the jumps doesn't seem to be too peaky or aggressive, which is probably an attempt to reduce crashes and injuries, but we did notice how chewed up the track got during Friday's short riding sessions, particularly in the bowl turns. The red Texas clay seems soft and has plenty of moisture, so it'll be something to watch during these next few races, because it could either be soft, rutted, and very grippy, or become hard-packed, slick, and technical as it dries out in the stadium. The Daytona Supercross results brought the standings in both classes much closer, and only a handful of points split the top riders in the field. Ken Roczen maintains control of the 450 class by 2 points over Cooper Webb and 24 points over Eli Tomac. The long-standing rivalry between Roczen and Webb intensified at Daytona after the block pass at the start of the main event and the post-race remarks the two exchanged. We're very eager to see what happens next between the two, but they kept their distance from each other on Friday. Roczen put in lots of laps on his Team Honda HRC CRF 450R and threw whips over the finish line, while Webb worked with the Red Bull KTM team to sort out the suspension setup of his 450 SXF. Tomac, meanwhile, has watched it all from afar and could end up being the biggest benefactor of it all. Cameron McAdoo's 250 main event win at Daytona was huge for the Monster Energy Pro Circuit Kawasaki rider. It was the first feature victory of his professional career and moved him to the top of the 250 West Coast region. McAdoo's bike is now complete with the red plates, and he has a 4-point advantage over Justin Cooper. We noticed that only a few KTM Husqvarna and GasGas motorcycles were outfitted with WP's air shock on Friday. The innovative part was on most of the European factory bikes at Houston 1, but by round 10, only Marvin Muscan and Justin Barcia had it installed. That's not to say that the parts rollout has been a failure. It's won races, finished on the podium, and is constantly being tested by riders and teams. Multiple racers have explained that they prefer the consistent feel that the pneumatic shock offers, but a lack of testing in the preseason and a shortage of parts has forced them to stick with what they know. It's always cool to see new technology in the pits, and we'll keep an eye on this all season. We'll close this one out with some updates on riders in the field. Justin Brayton is back with the Muckoff Honda team, but he told us that his chest is still very sore from a practice crash that happened nearly a month ago. JB10 explained that he managed to get in less than an hour of riding this week at Club MX, but he feels fit enough to go racing and put in some practice laps on Friday. Brock Tickle had a hard crash at the halfway point of the Daytona main event and was unable to finish the race, which forced him to take it easy this past week. Rested and somewhat recovered, the Smart Top, Bullfrog Spa's Moto Concepts Honda rider, rode on Friday and will race on Saturday. Tickle isn't the only sore rider at MCR, because Shane McElrath skipped Friday's riding session due to a sore back. Something he says came out of nowhere and feels somewhat similar to the pain that sidelined him for a bit when he rode for TLD KTM in 2019. Zach Osborne and Adam Cincirillo will be absent from Arlington's lineup, Osborne for his still aching back, and Cincirillo for his recently fractured collarbone. The 2-week break between Arlington and Atlanta will give both riders additional time to heal and get back on the bike before the final leg of the season. Jordan Smith didn't ride on Friday, which allowed some more time for the 20 stitches on his buttocks to heal up, but he aims to race on Saturday. The Pro Circuit team told us the injury was quite gruesome and was inches away from being much worse, if you know what I mean. Silly season is starting up, and we've already heard some rumors about new deals in the pits. With multiple top-tier riders at the end of their current contracts, this could be a huge year for riders and teams. Thanks for watching, and as always, like and subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow our social media accounts, and visit Swapmoto Live for the latest updates from the track. Talk to you guys soon.